In this video, we're solving a problem where we have a mass attached to a spring that's hanging vertically, and this spring is initially at its relaxed length. Then we release the system from rest, and the mass is going to fall downward, causing the spring to stretch. And eventually we get to a maximum stretch length for the spring, where we have this turning point, and the mass is going to spring back upward after that point. Now we have two parts to the problem, and in the first part, we're looking for that maximum stretch length. And in the second part, we're looking for the maximum speed of the mass on its way down. And both of these are energy conservation problems. So starting with the maximum stretch length problem, we can state energy conservation generally as E initial equals E final. And we have to think about what types of energy we're looking at in the initial and final state. So for this problem, the initial state is the stationary mass being released from rest at the very top of its motion. So there's no kinetic energy there. All the energy there is gravitational potential energy. And then in the final state, the mass is at its turning point. So it's at this maximum stretch length. It's turning around. It's momentarily stationary there. So again, there's no kinetic energy in this final state. But we can say all the energy is now in the spring potential energy. In other words, the stretching of the spring. So I've already implicitly said this, but let's just make it clear what our Y coordinate system is for measuring gravitational potential energy here. So what I'm going to do is say that my final Y value is zero. It's just convenient to call zero the lowest point in the problem. And this means my initial Y value, well, that's actually the same thing as X max itself, the maximum stretch length of the spring. So now we can plug in our energy terms in the initial and final state. And in my initial state, I have just purely the gravitational potential energy of this mass because the spring is relaxed. There's no spring potential energy there. And in my final state, I'm at a Y coordinate of zero, so there's no gravitational potential energy. It's all spring potential energy. So that's 1/2 K X max squared. Now we do get two solutions to this problem. One solution is that X max is equal to zero, but we're clearly not interested in that solution. So I'm going to divide out one factor of X max. And now we can solve for the X max that we're actually interested in. So we multiply both sides by 2, and we divide by K. And we end up with an X max, a maximum stretch length, of 2 mg over K. Now the second part of the problem is actually the more challenging one. We want the maximum speed in terms of m, g, and K. And the reason this is more challenging is we have to do some reasoning about how different forces compare in order to determine the stretch length where the maximum speed should occur. So what's going on as this mass moves further and further down in the middle of this process is that I have a competition between two different forces acting on this mass. Gravity is going to be pulling down with a magnitude of mg, and the spring is going to be pulling up with a magnitude of kx. That's just Hooke's law. And at first, the stretch of the spring is really small, so kx is really small. Mg is always the same. So at first, mg is winning, and I have a net force downward, and the mass is accelerating downward. But eventually, the stretch length gets to the point where it begins to exceed the force of gravity, and the mass starts slowing down again. Well, the point where the speed is maximum is that point where it stops accelerating downward. In other words, the moment where kx is equal to mg. That's the moment where the mass stops speeding up and it starts slowing down. And after that moment, kx is going to be greater than mg, and the mass is going to move slower and slower. So this is the stretch length that we're interested in investigating. And we can solve this really quickly for x. X is just mg over k at the location of the maximum speed. So now we can use energy conservation again. And we're using the same initial state where the mass is originally released from rest. But now the final state is this special moment where kx is equal to mg. So starting from the beginning, we can say E initial is equal to E final. And again, we should be clear about the Y coordinate that we're using for measuring gravitational potential energy here. And I'm going to make this choice again to call the Y coordinate zero at the lowest point in the analysis of the problem. So it's going to be zero at that point of maximum speed. And that means my initial Y value is going to be mg over k, because we figured out that's the stretch length of the spring when we hit the maximum speed. So now looking at the initial energy in the system, that's purely the gravitational potential energy of this mass when it was released from rest. So that's going to be mg times the initial Y value, which is mg over k. In the final state, we have kinetic energy and we have spring potential energy. So our kinetic energy is 1/2 m times v max squared, and that's what we're hoping to solve for, that v max, plus my spring potential energy, which is 1/2 kx squared. But we already figured out our stretch length at this point of interest is mg over k. So we need to take that x of mg over k and square it. All right, so everything is set up and we just have a bit of algebra to work through. So I want to point out in this final term on the right-hand side, I end up with an mg all squared in the numerator, and that's the same thing I see on the left side of the equation, does an mg times an mg. When I square this piece in parentheses, that produces a k squared in the denominator, but then one of those is going to cancel because of the k out in front. So it's really just an mg all squared divided by k with a 1/2 out in front. So I'll go ahead and put in one step in between to highlight what I'm saying here. But on the left-hand side, I have mg all squared over k. And on the right side, 1/2 m v max squared plus 1/2 times a term that looks exactly like the one on the left side, mg all squared divided by k. So now I can subtract 1/2 mg all squared divided by k. And if I take one of those on the left and I subtract 1/2 of one of those, it leaves me with half of one of those on the left. So I have 1/2 mg all squared divided by k on the left side, and then on the right, 1/2 m v max squared. So now I can multiply both sides by 2, and my 1/2s are gone. And all I have to do now is divide by m and square root the result. So dividing by m means that instead of an m squared on the left side, I now have just a single m. So I end up with an m times g squared divided by k. That's equal to the square of my maximum speed. And finally, I can solve for my maximum speed. So v max is going to be the square root of this thing. So we can write that all as a single square root and say it's the square root of mg squared divided by k. Now, if you prefer, you could pull that factor of g squared out of the square root and just write it as a g out in front of square root m over k, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.